It is now our clinical judgment that the time to lay out a plan for COVID-19 boosters is now. Recent data makes clear that protection against mild and rare disease has decreased over time. This is likely due to both waning immunity and the strength of the widespread Delta variant.
Federal health officials now recommending a third COVID-19 vaccination. Joining us now to discuss what you need to know about the COVID-19 booster shot is Dr. Victor Waters. He is the Chief Medical Officer of Dignity Health St. Bernardine in San Bernardino. I think I got that right. Dr. Waters, thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
Okay, so this booster shot, the CDC is recommending it after 8 months. Why 8 months? Because I think a lot of people, you think about the flu vaccine, we have to get that annually, but why under a year's time?
You know, we're in a major epidemic and we have to follow the data. So CDC has confirmed studies that after 8 months, the immunity wanes. And what that means is the antibody levels designed to protect and guard you from getting sick and admitted to the hospital or even die puts those people who have had early vaccinations at risk.
So who should be getting the booster shot then? You say after 8 months, which people should be getting the booster shots? And what about the rest of us? When should we be thinking about getting the booster shot?
It's a very important question. Right now, it's a prioritization. Priority is to the immunocompromised right now. Those people who have been on chemotherapy, cancer, patients who are immunocompromised are at highest risk for breakthrough infections and getting sick, and very sick quickly. The other classification is healthcare workers. Many healthcare workers, including myself, got vaccinated early as January. And we are at particular risk because we're frontline workers, we're around the COVID, and we're in the midst of a fourth surge. That's important. And the next level will be, according to CDC, in the later future, September, after September 20th, all members can be offered the third dose if they've had their vaccine over 8 months.
Okay, so the general population then, once the FDA, though, officially authorizes the booster shot, if I'm not mistaken, and that is expected to happen in mid-September. So for me, right, and Bob, we got our shots in, I think, April. So then that means 8 months. That puts us, Marla, do the math quickly, maybe in January, November.
Maybe the most important thing is understand that you need to continue to practice safe social distancing, masking. You need to do the same things you've done when you weren't vaccinated during this surge, because Delta variant is highly infectious. Even those who have been vaccinated can spread the virus. So that's really important to understand, that you practice. People are having breakthroughs are sort of, hey, I can do whatever I want now. I can go eat in a restaurant in clothes, take my mask off and eat. Well, that may not be the wisest thing. I advise as a physician that you be outdoors, you practice the same practice of social distancing as much as possible. That is really what we need to do, whether you're vaccinated or not. But of course, if you're not, get vaccinated.
So as it stands, as booster shots apply to the Pfizer and the Moderna shots, right? So let's talk about the Johnson & Johnson, because I actually know people who got the Johnson & Johnson because they were like, woohoo, I only get to have to do one shot. But this does not apply to the Johnson & Johnson vaccine?
Well, for the most part, people have gotten the Moderna and Pfizer vaccine. The J&J, there's still policy trying to be determined what, where, and how, meaning whether you can give a Moderna or Pfizer or give the J&J. We don't know the recommendation right now, but that's an excellent question. At this point, it's under deliberation, trying to figure out what is the best next step for J&J. It's a great question.
All right, and I do know that the CDC put out a statement saying it, J&J recipients will probably need a booster. So that won't be a big surprise once that happens.
It won't be a big surprise, and more likely than not, because we have adequate supplies, we won't need to do a crossover. More likely than not, we'll continue to give J&J as a booster.
All right, Dr. Waters, thank you so much for your guidance. We appreciate your time.
Thanks, doctor.